Yeah, thank you that I can speak some words about recycling, especially if the dismantling, processing, new approaches. Ian said some in some slides quite the same, but I want to look more in a technical issue about the process and the recycling things. I go over a little bit quite fast about Fraunhofer. I hope that everybody knows Fraunhofer. Fraunhofer is the number one applied research in Europe. And we, one of the 72 institutions, maybe it's two more in the meantime, and we are located in Bremerhaven. And we are dealing with everything with rotor blade, and meaning rotor blade testing and also other things. How we are earn our money? Yeah, the Fraunhofer Gesellschaft is an institution what is on the market, on the rotor blade market. It means that not a half, but 35% are projects what we make directly with companies in the market. The others is public fundings and public revenue. But this is only in short word. Yeah, what we do in our department where I'm located, the rotor blade department, we are dealing with composite technology. We have a manufacturing facility, means that not only laboratory, means that we have an own mold, a 31 meter mold and a 40 meter mold, and we're producing rotor blades. You see it in my background. These are not turbines for the rotor blades for the turbines. These are research rotor blades where we implemented things what are new, maybe some deviations, maybe some new materials, also then materials what we could starting with the recycling. Blade test is one big issue. Clearly, I think everybody know us for the blade testing. Then we are starting virtual test rig and a new group what is still in founding is recyclability and sustainability. Yeah, how does it look a rotor blade concerning, maybe for concerning the recycling? We have the main spar caps, leading edge spar caps, trailing edge spar caps. In the older blades, what now coming for recycling for the end of life is mostly glass fiber. In the newer blades are mostly carbon fiber. Carbon fiber is an issue about the recycling. We hear this later was. But in the old blades, it's still glass, but the problem will come. Then we have sandwich panels there, leading edge and trailing edge side. Sandwich is with balsa wood, foam, PVC, PET or similar. Then we have glue in for the part. Yeah, clearly not in all blades. There are some companies, they not use glue, but we are, as a generic composite blade, have gluing on the leading edge, trailing edge, and the shear webs. And some metal is there, copper wire, steel balls, or studs, what have to separate it afterwards. Means that as we are speaking about recycling of rotor blade, it's not only one material, it's a combination of material, what we have looked for very in detail and different. As we look these materials there, then we have, yeah, clearly the landfill is the thing what they do. Then the chemical using means, yeah, I name it the burning. Then downcycling to have as a filler, or we can use it as a secondary material. And in the highlighted in the top is then use it as a part for other things, maybe for rotor blades, for a new life. And in this field, yeah, the automated cutting of the rotor blades is a challenge. I will show you some slides about this, because we have big parts, we are heavy, and we have to cut the different parts out of it to recycle it separately. separately. Okay, what suitable process methods we have? What Ian showed us is the co-processing process, mechanical grinding, also high voltage pulse fragmentation, gasification, pyrolyse, and solvolyse. These methods are theoretically used for the different parts, but not at all will happen in the future, and especially get us the challenge to come from the landfill to really to reuse. I want to look a little bit in the detail about the co-processing. The co-processing is the most common today's method to disposal blades. That is what we heard from the German company. They do something, take it in a rotation cement killing, 1,300 Celsius, and all types of waste will effectively disposed. The result is that we get not ash, we get some heat, but the part is this process is not used for carbon, because they want to have in his process no carbon. So for carbon laminate, we have to use another thing coming to this. That maybe could be the pyrolyse. The pyrolyse is a process what gas out, liquid and solid products are decomposed, and we have temperature between 400 and 700 degrees. And the problem is that it's not really an economical value at the moment. And it's a fiber product, what is in the end there, may retain with a lot of oxidation and not could use for FRP usings. There's maybe the solvolyse, the more challenge what we're looking for. Solvolyse means that in a very variation process, the condition takes from 70 degree, not high temperature, with atmospheric pressure up to an overcritical condition. But means that the polymer structures are decomposed to monomers, and getting free the fibers as it is, and may produce in the end the fibers for a new lamination. It's in the starting, but have to say we need a lot of energy to do it, and we can only use it as we exactly know the matrix what is in the rotor blade. We cannot mixing the max matrix in the solvolysis, then we get not the material back what we can use again for really an highly usage for resin. I take this because the old blades what is in the field, some of the blade producer existing, some of them not, or not exactly what they know 20 years ago, it's not really documented anymore or not anymore known. This is a point what have to before analysis what is material, exactly material is there. Okay, coming to next issue, we have big blades, we have big parts, and these big parts have to cut it in pieces. There are some two pictures there. One is a picture what we see as we are cut it an 83 meter blade. Okay, it's a big blade, but then we see there's a challenge. You cannot cutting some pieces and take it away by a forklifter or with your hands. And on the left side, you see a picture where is the cutting made today with a big diamond saw. But you see also that they hold the big parts in position, that not falling down. It's it's not so that it's a dismantling by a factory and quite easy. Yeah, there you see some dimensions there, like a little bit like an airplane fuselage, but it was a part of the blade where we cut the trailing edge away and then have even a 4 meter high shear web. In the end have to cut it there. You see on the left side is there's also some carbon in. This is why we are cut the spar caps away from the rest of the glass laminate. And yeah, for this dismantling, it takes in our example 1 week. 1 week for one blade. Here's some pictures for an dismantling by a diamond rope saw. In the middle of the picture, you see maybe the saw. This is a relative small blade, 31 meter. It functioned quite well, but you can imagine as we have the size of the blade 3 times more, and this is then the normal size. Also, the saw and the equipment have to quite big. I hope that now the film is functioning. There's a film takes in 2 minutes the dismantling, what's in the normal time take by us 1 week, and it was made from the roof from our laboratory, and it was in our yard where it's happened there. Sometimes it getting wet, that means it's raining. This is also a point that outside sometimes raining, and the heavy rain helps not really the working there. What I see is some water spray. It's not calming, but it was quite windy in this time. And the taking the pieces away, it takes a while. This is what I want to show with there. And in the end, on the flange area, it getting complicated. Yeah, there comes the containers between for transported away to the disposal. Just have to be quite carefully that the parts not falling down, and danger for the guys, they do it. For the big series of disposal what coming in the next years, we have to find solutions for also automated this in a part there. Even on the field and or in dismantling centers, as I name it. They're only cutting the parts out, cutting the carbon parts out, cutting the foam and balsa panels away for separate the recycling. Okay. This was the dismantling of the 83 meter blade. I have another film there, only a bit showing the cutting of the with the diamond rope saw. You see it goes through quite easy, a little bit water there, what we catch it. Is a quite similar principle, but this is maybe more made or more substantial for automatization and using in a factory for this. Okay, this was some practical issues. Let's start again. And some new trends, what we are looking for. And we see that the industry had his challenges and make some projects to come in the future. Well named the first as the SEPA project. They have the aim to 100 recyclable composite wind turbine blades with the optimized concerning manufacturing. This the project partner is Arkema, so resin supplier LM, clearly as a rotor blade manufacturer. May Martijn tell us about this. Owns Corning as a fiber or glass fiber and carbon supplier. And we'll see that the SEPA project coming near the recycled composite wind turbine blades. The next thing is the CETEC project. It's a project between Vestas, Olin as a resin supplier, and DTU and some others. They have the aim to enable a thermoset composite to make the wind turbines recyclable. Means that the resin is like the same as the SEPA project, is usable for reuse it in the new blades. Maybe with the solvolysis, they can take it there, and also the fibers should be used again. And at last is the project recyclable blade. You heard it that Siemens Gamesa announced that I already produced blades for an offshore wind park, 81 meter long, which should be in the end 100% recyclability. From all the projects, we'll see what's happened. And from our side, and I think also from your side, we'll look and see what's happened there in the future. I have to say that has nothing to do with the old plates, with the old turbines, what's coming for the next 20 years, but it's a good step for the future. Okay. So far, thank you for your attention.
So thank you, Niels, from the lofty ideas at the Wind Europe to the brutal reality of today. because you did overrun your time a little bit, I will allow one or two questions if they are. I've got actually one in the chat, which was still for the previous presenter, but it doesn't really matter. Maybe you can answer as well. The idea was that, okay, composite blades are not particularly toxic, they don't react, but the question by Cecilia Matson was, blades have other components, right? Like PVC plastics, for instance. Are those non-toxic either? So can you actually scrap the thing, put it in a landfill, put earth over it and forget about it?
No. The PVC and especially newer used PET, as you can take it away from the fiber and the resin, then you can use this PVC for react for isolation plates in one of our Fraunhofer Institute dealing with this, with the balsa wood and also with the PVC and PET, the foam, to reuse it afterwards at the moment for isolation plates in houses. This is not good for the landfill itself. We have to avoid totally the landfill. This is the worst thing what we can do. We're not known afterwards what's happened in 100 or 200 years with the particles in the landfill, because we have in the end particles there.
Okay. I think that's the first answer to the question, but we can also keep it for further things. Thanks very much, Niels, for being with us. If not in person, then at least online. See you.